The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 8th chapter, text number 37, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 29th, 1973, in Los Angeles.
Translation. O my Lord, you have executed all duties yourself.
Are you leaving us today, though we are completely dependent on your mercy, and have no one else to protect us, now when all kings are at enmity with us?
This conversation was going on between Kunti and Krishna, when Krishna was going home after establishing the Pandavas in their kingdom, and finishing the battle of Kurukshetra, Krishna is going back home, Dwarka, and was taking leave, farewell, from the aunt. And that time, Kunti offered this prayer. Now he is asking directly that after finishing your duty, is it a fact that you are going away, leaving us alone? This is the devotee's position. Here he said, Jivisham nasa anyat bhavata pradhamya. We have no other means of protection than your lotus feet. This is our position. Anyat. Anyat means anything else. This is full surrender. Just like Narottam Das Thakur sings, Haha Prabhu Nanda Suto Vrisa Bhanu Suta Juto. Nanda Suta, Krishna, and you are present here with the daughter of King Vrisa Bhanu. Both of you are here. Aha Prabhu Nanda Suta Vrishabhanu Suta Juta. We don't want to see Krishna alone. Why everyone is coming? What is the difficulty? Yesterday also I heard. What is the difficulty? You have no sufficient warm cloth. You are affected. That you must arrange. You must take care of your health. Yukta ahara viharasya yoga bhavati siddhyate. Bhagavad Gita, it is said, yukta ahara. You should take food just to maintain your health nicely. Similarly, other necessities of body must be taken care of. If you become diseased, then how can you execute Krishna consciousness? Just like Brahmananda could not go today. So we must be careful. We should not eat more or less. Better eat less than eat more. You will not die by eating less, but you will die eating more. People die for overeating, not for under-eating. This should be the principle. The medical science always forbids not to eat more than you require. Voracious eating is the cause of diabetes. And undernourishment is the cause of tuberculosis. This is the medical science. So we should not take under, neither more. In children case, they can commit the mistake of taking more. But adult, they cannot commit this mistake, taking more. Children, they can digest. And all day they are playing. Anyway, we should take care of our health also. Goswami, you are suffering from itches very much. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was embracing him. So the itches were wet itches. There are two kinds of itches, white and dry. Sometimes itching spot is dry. And sometimes it is wet. After itching it becomes wet. So Sanatana Goswami's body was all covered with wet itches. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was embracing him. So the wetness, the moisture was sticking to the body of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. See, he felt it very much, saying that I am suffering from itches, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is embracing, and the wet thing is snaring over the body. How much I am unfortunate. So he decided that tomorrow I shall commit suicide instead of allowing me to be embraced by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So next day Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inquired that you have decided to commit suicide. So do you think this body is yours? So you are silent. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, we have already dedicated this body to me, how we can kill it? Similarly, of course, from that day his itches were all cured. But this is the decision, that our body, those who are Krishna conscious, those who are working for Krishna, they should not think that the body belongs to him. It is already dedicated to Krishna. So it must be kept very carefully without any neglect, just like you are taking care of the temple because it is Krishna's place. Similarly, we should not take over care, but some care we should take so that we may not fall disease. Anyway, so Kunti Devi says, Jisa nacha annat bhavata padam bhuja. This is called full dependence. In the Saranagati, in the surrender process, there are six things. The six things is the completely, one of the completely dependent on Krishna. Anukullasa sankalpa. The first sarnagati is to accept everything favorable for Krishna's service. Anukullam. Anukullina Krishnanu silanam bhakti uttama. Devotional first class bhakti means accepting everything which is favorable for devotional service. And pratikullam vivarjanam. And reject everything which is unfavorable to the procedure of Krishna consciousness. So we forbid that you don't do this because they are unfavorable. And we say something, you do this, chant Hare Krishna 16, that is favorable. Saranagati means to give up the unfavorable things and to accept the favorable. Anukulla sa sankalpa, pratikullam vivarjan. And believe that Krishna will give me protection, full faith. And to count oneself as one of the servants of Krishna. In this way, Saranagati. So here Kunti says that if you think, my dear Krishna, now we are well established, we have got our kingdom back, so everything is nicely done, so you want to leave us, that is not a very good proposal. Because we are not free as yet. because you have killed so many kings, all their relatives and friends, they are also planning to come and again fight with us. This is our position. Parayanam rajasu jujitam hasa. They are still engaged. So, you don't think that we are already free from all dangerous conditions. We are not. And we have no other protection except your lotus feet. This is our position. So indirectly he was asking, Krishna, do not leave us. Don't think that we are safe now. We are not safe. Without your protection, we are always unsafe. This should be the position of the devotee. We are actually in a dangerous position, this material world. At any time, Maya will catch. At any time. As soon as we are little inattentive, now I have done my duty, now let me take rest little. No, there is no rest. We must be always alert. There is a verse from Srila Rupa Goswami. What is that? Abhartha kalattam. Abhartha kalattam. A devotee should be so much careful that he should see whether my time is unnecessarily being spent. Whether I am now engaged in Maya service or Krishna service. That one should be very much alert. Abhartha kalattam namagane sadaruchi priti tat vasasi sthale. These are the symptoms of advanced devotees. What is that? Namagane sadaruchi. He is never tired of chanting or singing or dancing. No tiresome feeling. Namagane sada. Sada means always. Ruchi. Taste. Very nice. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Rama, Rama, Rama. This is the test. But this test, to awaken this test, it takes time to become, just like Rupa Goswami. When he was chanting, he was thinking, I am working only one tongue and 2 ears. What I shall chant? He was thinking, if I could get millions of tongues and trillions of ears, then I could realize something by chanting and hearing. This was the... So we should not imitate, but at least we must be very careful to complete the 16 down at the minimum. Namagane sadaruchi. We have to increase our taste for singing and chanting. Namagane sadaruchi. Priti stat basati sthale. And we should increase our inclination to live in the place where Krishna is living. Krishna is living everywhere. That is the vision of higher devotees. Actually he is living. But still, because we are in the lower condition, we should know that here is Krishna in the temple. Krishna is everywhere. But for us, because we have no such vision to see Krishna anywhere and everywhere, therefore we should come here in the temple and see Krishna. Here is Krishna. Krishna has kindly appeared here in a manner in which I can see him. That is Krishna's mercy. That is temple. We cannot see Krishna has complete spiritual body, but we have no eyes to see what is a spiritual body. Satchidananda vigraha. We are accustomed to see this material, jara, gross things. We can see stone, we can see metal, we can see wood, we can see all these material elements. But Krishna is everything. Therefore, to be visible to our imperfect eyes, Krishna has appeared in the stone form. But Krishna is not stone. It is not that we are worshipping stone. We are worshipping Krishna. But because we cannot see except stone, therefore Krishna has kindly appeared in the form carved from the stone. This is the conclusion. So, priti sat bhatasi sthale. So one should be very much inclined to live within the sakala temple environment. Narugane sadaruchi, and increase our inclination to chant more and more. Narugane sadaruchi, priti sat bhatasi sthale. And one thing, always thinking dependent on Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. Always thinking that without Krishna, my life is useless. I am in danger. Actually, we are in dangerous position without Krishna. So Krishna, Kunti is offering that prayer. That you, Krishna, you are thinking that now we are safe. But I don't think we are safe. We are always in danger. So, if you think that we are safe, then who will give us protection? Because we have no other protection except your lotus feet. Jishang nacha anyat bhavata padambuja. Padambuja. Pada means feet, ambuja means lotus. So, except your lotus feet, we have no other shelter. We have no other shelter. And so for our safety is concerned, we are already encircled by so many enemies, because in the fight, one's father has died, so his son is preparing to fight with us, so we are not at all free now. So, apadyanasyam sakite hitam prabho. Now Krishna is addressed as prabho. Although Krishna has come to Kunti Devi to take the dust of his feet, of her feet, she is superior aunt, but Kunti Devi is addressing him, the prabho, the Lord. Kunti Devi is not addressing him. He is asking his beloved nephew, but she knows that Krishna, although playing the part of my nephew, my brother's son, still he is Prabhu, he is the Supreme Master. Therefore he is addressing Prabhu. Jihasasi. Jihasasi means, are you actually leaving us? Jihasasi. Sit. Suhida. Suhida means those who are well-wisher. Anujivina. Anujivina means they are living under your mercy only. Our life is always under your mercy. So these things, these are the symptoms of really Krishna conscious person, that one should think always in danger without Krishna. This is the first step. By taking shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, one should always feel safe. Now I am under the protection. Krishna says, Kauntiya pratijanihi nami bhakta pranasyati. It is a fact. If you become a pure devotee of Krishna, there is no question of danger. Krishna gives protection to everyone. Without his protection, nobody can live even for a single moment. That's a fact. So, if you think that Krishna is giving protection to everyone, then what is the use of becoming a special devotee? No, there is use. Just like the king gives protection to everyone of the citizens, that is his duty. But he has got special protection for his own men. This is the distinction. This is not unnatural. One is directly engaged in Krishna, the governance or the president's service. So when he is in some difficulty, he has got some special protection. Although President Nixon is giving protection as president to every citizen, but those who are personally associated with him, giving him this service, they are special considerers. That is not unnatural. That is natural. That is not partiality. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that samoham sarvabhuteshu, that I am equal to everyone. He is God. How he can be partial to somebody and partial to somebody? No. Samoham. That is samatha. That is natural. When a gentleman loves all children, but he has special love for his own children. That is natural. That is not partiality. Nobody will say, oh, why you are loving your own children more than others? No, that is natural. This is not partiality. Similarly, Krishna loves everyone because everyone is part and parcel of Krishna. But he takes special care of the devotee. Therefore he says, Kuntiya pratijani hi nami bhakta pranashrati. His bhakta, his devotee, will never be. He is always alert to see the comforts of the devotees. And the devotees are always busy to see how Krishna is satisfied by dressing him, by supplying him food, by serving him, always engaged. Similarly, Krishna is also always engaged to see how my devotees will be happy. This is process going on. This is intimate relationship with Krishna. The ordinary living entity, they have got relationship. But when one becomes devotee, it is intimate relation, intimate parent. Therefore, Kunti is requesting Krishna that how you can leave us? We are your intimate friends. And Anujivino. Anujivino means we are simply living by your care, by your mercy. So don't think that we are safe and you are leaving us and we have no other shelter than your lotus feet. Kindly don't leave us. This is Kunti's prayer. Similarly, Narottamdas Thakur says, Aha Prabhu Nanda Suta Vishabhanu Suta Juta Karuna Karaha Eva. Now I am fully surrendered. You can show your mercy because without Krishna consciousness, when one thinks that I shall protect myself, my society will protect me, my community will protect me, my state will give me protection, what do I care for God? This is the general tendency. So I have got so many protection. Why shall I go to Krishna? These rascals, those who have more protection, they can go to Krishna. That is their view. But that is not the fact. Unless Krishna gives you protection, there is no protection. This is stated in the Srimad Bhagavata. Balasya nehas saranam pitaro nisinga. When Prahlad Maharaj is offering prayer to Krishna, Nisingade, he said, my dear Lord, balasya, for the children, it is not to be thought that because one child has got father and mother, he has got full protection. No, that is not. If Krishna does not give protection to a child, in spite of having thousands of father and mother, he will not be protected. This is the path. Similarly, he says, Natasachagada mudan ratamajatu. No. It is not that good physician or good medicine can give one protection. No. Suppose one is suffering from some disease and one is very rich man, he engages first class physician, first class medicine is being. Does it mean that his life is guaranteed? No. If Krishna does not give him protection, despite all supply of good medical treatment and medicine, he'll die. This is a fact. Similarly, if you have got good, nice boat, it is not guarantee that you will not drown in the ocean. No, at any moment, if Krishna does not give you protection, this is our position. So we may have invented so many counteraction for our protection. There is scientific advancement, struggle for existence. Nature is offering difficulties, and the human being, so-called scientists, they are trying to invent something to check this difficulty. This is called struggle for existence. But it is not possible. Unless Krishna gives you protection, your invention has no use. So Kunti knows it. Although Kunti happens to be the mother of big warriors, Arjuna, Bhima, still she thinks that they are not sufficient to give us protection. My sons are so big warriors. But that is not protection. Accept yourself. Therefore she says, Jishan nocha anyat. It is not that anyone can give us protection except your lotus feet. So this is a very nice verse for the surrendered soul seeking the protection of Krishna. And if we remain in that position, that our only protector is Krishna, and our only duty is to serve Krishna, then our life is successful. Thank you.